Any other public comment?
My name is Debbie Martinez. Mr. Poe, Gainesville residents have noticed that you have become more and more erratic and abusive as many new voices have begun to appear at city commission meetings. They have expressed opposition to the regressive decisions you have spearheaded and championed as mayor. These decisions approved by the commissioners you oversee as mayor have exacerbated disparities, inequities, and have grown more pronounced in the 12 years since you first were elected to the commission. You have championed and achieved the expenditure of hundreds of thousands of dollars to militarize City Hall and invest it with a before dawn and after dusk armed private security squad. You have manipulated and violated this chamber's rules of procedure, violated your own procedural rules, repeatedly attempted to limit free speech, and directed police officers to physically remove from this lectern well-informed, concerned, retired Democratic residents in their 60s, 70s, and 80s as they have attempted to offer their perspectives and solutions to problems of your making. Over the last week, you have gone further. You issued a letter on letterhead without the city's, on the city letterhead, without the city's commission's approval, attacking not just your Democratic constituents, but also attacking locally elected legislators who listened to the concerns of longtime Gainesville Democratic residents and recently arrived Gainesville Democratic residents who have become alarmed by your decisions as mayor and who have tried to present evidence of financial, operational, and management irregularities that have occurred during your 3.5 years as mayor. Equally appalling has been your attack on the character of this city's respected former internal auditor, Carlos Holt, a decorated military veteran, certified public accountant, and certified fraud examiner, who more than 4 years of dedicated service to the city included repeated identification of instances of lacking of and failed internal controls, operational management deficiencies, many of which have yet to be effectively dealt with. As you know, Mr. Poe, a year ago, Mr. Holt's office was in the process of reopening an audit of a city program that, unknown to the public, had begun and was shelved in 2010 during your first year on the commission. Mr. Poe, you and then City Manager Anthony Lyons met to discuss Mr. Holt's family life. Complete details of what was discussed in the meeting are known only by you and Mr. Lyons, who has since resigned. But after that meeting, the Gainesville Police Department, whose chief reported to Mr. Lyons, launched an investigation of Mr. Holt and his family.
Ms. Martinez, thank you.
Hello, my name is Bob Tuning. As you know, Mr. Poe, when that GPD investigation concluded, a confidential police report was issued that contained no findings of professional or personal misconduct by Mr. Holt. Despite that outcome, you and two of your confederates on the dais began what appears to have been an orchestrated campaign to force Mr. Holt to abandon ongoing audits of city operations or resign. As you know, Mr. Poe, the police report, which contained medical and mental health information pertaining to Mr. Holt's wife and confidential information about his minor children, was leaked by an employee of the city. Your actions, the actions of your confederates, and the actions of the as yet unrevealed city employee made Mr. Holt's family's continued residence in Gainesville difficult, if not untenable. As a result, Mr. Holt hired legal counsel to attempt to negotiate a possible settlement agreement. After Mr. Holt's attorney communicated his settlement attempt, you and your confederates on this commission, Commissioner Adrian Hayes Santos and Commissioner Harvey Ward, oversaw a charge joined by Commissioner David Areola that resulted in a narrow vote to fire Mr. Holt without legal cause. As you know, Mr. Poe, Mr. Holt and his family have moved on to a more welcoming city than the city that Gainesville has become during your problematic time as mayor. how they may be doing as they attempt to rebuild lives turned upside down by actions you approved or set in motion may not matter to you, but it does matter to many of us who welcome them into our community, who appreciate the years they spent with us, and who will be forever grateful for the service Mr. Holt provided before you and your Confederates cut that service short. As you know, Mr. Poe, when you and your Confederates learned 2 weeks ago that Mr. Holt had been called upon to assist a bipartisan legislative committee considering whether to direct the state's independent auditor general to send her professional staff to conduct an audit of Gainesville City government operations and managerial oversight, you took part in a coordinated effort to smear Mr. Holt. You wrote a post on Facebook that accused Mr. Holt of attempting to extort city taxpayers. Your lieutenant, new city manager Lee Feldman, derided Mr. Holt as a disgruntled employee in an interview with a local news reporter, implying that you and your Confederates had fired Mr. Holt for some unidentified impropriety. Mr. Poe, if I continue attempting to communicate the appalling actions of you and your Confederates, I know I risk being escorted out. But there is more of this story to come.
Thank you, Mr. Tuning. Next.
Mayor Pro Tem, I'm James Thompson. I'm here as a member of the Alachua County Charter Review Commission. Can I put this on the...
Sure. If we get the overhead, please.
I guess I should have washed all the paint off my hands. As I said, I'm a member of the Alachua County Charter Review Commission. That's not to be confused, as many do, with the Gainesville City Charter Review Commission. We are structured in the same way, but we are a 12-member board appointed by the County Commission to listen to public input from residents across the county and to propose any amendments to the county charter that deserve to be voted upon by its citizens. And my understanding from working with my colleagues on the county CRC is that we are assertively devoted to transparency and eager for vigorous public involvement. To that end, we are traveling to each of the city commissions in our county and informing citizens and their governing bodies about public access platforms and our contact info. And that's what I have here up on the screen for our viewers at home and for the public record. At this site, any citizen, the public, may submit a proposed amendment to the County Charter Review Commission. Those citizens can also view each and every document that comes our way across our desk and that we share among ourselves. Thank you, and I'm happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. It's nice to see Kurt Lannon's name up there. Yeah.
Yes, it is. He's great.
All right. Next up for public comment.
Good afternoon. My name is Carol Messias. I am reading the 2019 Florida Statutes, Section 11.45. Definitions of duties, authorities, reports, rules. Abuse means behavior that is deficient or improper when compared with behavior that a prudent person would consider a reasonable and necessary operational practice given the facts and circumstances. This term includes the misuse of authority or position for personal gain. 1E, fraud, means obtaining something of value through willful misrepresentation, included but not limited to intentional misstatements or intentional omissions of amounts or disclosures in financial statements to deceive users of financial statements, theft of an entity's assets, bribery, or the use of one's position for personal enrichment, through the deliberate misuse or misapplication of an organization's resources. 1G, local governmental entity means a municipality. 1I, operational audit means an audit whose purpose is to evaluate management's performance in establishing and maintaining internal controls, including controls designed to prevent and detect fraud, waste and abuse, and in administering assigned responsibilities in accordance with applicable laws, administrative rules, contracts, grant agreements, and other guidelines. Such audits examine internal controls that are designed and placed in operation to promote and encourage the achievement of management's control objectives in the categories of compliance, economic and efficient operations, reliability of financial records and reports, and safeguarding of assets, and identify weaknesses in those internal controls. Political subdivision means and includes, but is not limited to, the following: of and the officers thereof, municipality. Waste means the action of using or expending resources unreasonably, carelessly, extravagantly, or for no useful purpose. 2, duties the auditor general shall, at least every 3 years, conduct a performance audit of the local government financial reporting system. The Auditor General shall determine the scope of the audits. The local government financial reporting system shall provide for the timely, accurate, uniform, and cost-effective accumulation of financial and other information that can be used by the members of the legislature and other appropriate officials to accomplish the following goals: enhance citizen participation in local government.
Thank you for your comments.
Mr. Mayor Pro Tem Jim Connish, I'm not going to acknowledge anything Belarski says from now on, except that where he came from, the mayor was under indictment, got reelected, and then was convicted of massive corruption. That's all I have to say about Mr. Belarski's ongoing rants. Thank goodness that our state elected officials went to the Joint Auditing Committee and called in the Auditor General on the City of Gainesville and GRU. I thank Keith Perry and Chuck Clemens for their leadership and their courage. The reason this is happening is because of massive and obvious irregularities. I'd like to just touch on a couple of things in this report. This is not 7 citizens. This is 7 dozen or 700 citizens that I worked for years to push back against the total breakdown of financial controls in the City of Gainesville. Commissioner Hayes Santos went on the internet, set up a GoFundMe account under the official seal of the City of Gainesville and begged for money. That's right. That is mentioned in this report, and I'm very familiar with this affair, and it's absolutely accurate. I have pointed out how you abuse the utility tax, the sales tax, the gross receipts tax. I've written a scholarly article. They agree that the Auditor General should take a look at my concerns, which are well documented. Your financial auditor didn't blow the whistle. He blew the trumpet for about 15 minutes. Clovis Watson was not heard from. The city lobbyist was not heard from. No one from the city was heard from. And then by unanimous vote, a bipartisan panel of elected state officials, both senators and members of the House of Representatives, ordered the Auditor General to come to town and investigate you for your actions. Mostly Democrats went to our Republican elected officials. And that is just a simple fact. It's not entirely clear to me, because normally the audits don't come through this mechanism, but it appears that the City of Gainesville will be billed for this audit. And if you're arrogant enough not to pay the bill, which is what I would expect from you, they'll deduct the money from the State Revenue Department by picking up the phone and calling the Department of Revenue. And their final report will be public, and you will take whatever corrective actions they find, or they will punish you mercilessly, because they have the ability to dissolve the City of Gainesville, which ultimately might happen in your bankruptcy proceeding. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Connish. Always good to hear from you.
Could I request a copy of his materials for the record?
Certainly. Mr. Connish?
Mr. Connish. Can I request a copy of your materials for the record?
Absolutely. You can go to my website, gruypaperboard.com. It's all on there.
Okay.
Love your personality.
Okay. Any more public comment? Any more public comment? Once more, any public comment? All right, Commissioner Hayes Santos.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. I just want to address a couple things. One, I Well, I don't think the audit is needed. I welcome an audit. I think it's our books are open, and look forward to it over the next year. But I do want to discuss one thing, saying the reasoning for the firing of Mr. Holt, and since he seems to be the central figure who is a disgruntled employee. Last year, the city commission received an email from his wife saying that she feared for his life from the actions of Mr. Holt. So an investigation was started by GPD in HR into the former auditor because his wife sent an email saying she feared for her life, for her safety. Investigation was put forward, multiple times the police being called to his house. There were serious concerns that were raised. And that was one of the, that was a major reasons of one of the reasons of what was going on. Things that shouldn't happen with an auditor. He lied. I caught him in a lie. That's the major reason. I don't want an auditor who lies. I think one of the most important things is for an auditor to be truthful and to be honest. Third, he tried to extort the city. He sent us a letter saying that we should give him hundreds of thousands of dollars or he'll sue us. He tried to extort us. That's not what an ethical auditor should do. Fourth, in that letter, he also asked to leave the city. He said that I think it's the best interest for me not be an employee at the city anymore, for Mr. Holt not to be an employee at the city. So those are the reasons why I believe Mr. Holt's not here. I think this is his effort to try to damage the city because he's not happy about what happened. But it's disturbing that that he has decided to go down this path. Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem.
Commissioner Earl.
Thank you. This light was actually for the gentleman from the Charter Review Commission. I don't know if he's out there listening, but am I to understand that Kurt Lannon has come out of retirement?
Kurt Lannon is the, as yeah. I understand it, is the clerk or the secretary or whatever the term might be of the, he's the staff person for the County Charter Review Commission, which is a limited.
It feels like when Urban Meyer retired just to go to Ohio State. It's like we weren't winning enough championships, I guess. Anyway, I wish him the best, of course. But I just wanted to say, commissioners, as the narrative begins to be said about the politics of an audit or the evaluation of one, I just want to remind commissioners, I don't believe it is a positive approach for us to engage in the kind of disparaging comments that are going to come from this. I think we ought to maintain a higher degree of standards. So I just want to say that because we're gonna be going through this for a little while.
Thank you, Commissioner. Anyone else? Okay, let's move on to the business of the day.